This is Josiah Plays Torment, Tides of Numenera. We are here in Caravanserai. You can tell because I'm moving my cursor in a vaguely rectangular motion around the name at the top of the map. And we are here to talk to Eritus at Master Radio. Oh god, it's time for the terrible French accent to come out. And I don't really remember what Eritus's voice is supposed to sound like either. So we sent him here because he stole... Eritus is the he in question. Eritus stole... Master Renio can fly us to the Valley of Dead Heroes where we want to go, but he won't fly us until he catches the thief who stole his airship. Eritus stole his airship. We went, we found the crashed airship, we found Eritus, we had a little chat with him, and we convinced him to come back. I convinced Eritus to go to Master Renio and apologize. I should meet up with them and see if they have resolved their dispute. Dispute? They don't have a dispute. Dude stole dude's airship and crashed it. That's not a dispute. That's a thing one guy did bad to the other guy and needs to make amends for. It's not a dispute. They're not... Never mind. Alright. Oh, we're putting off the loss of self thing because it's complicated. Alright. We're just getting started, and I've already lost a viewer. Of course I have. Eritus, Master Renio, let's do this. I'll get his forgiveness or die trying. If this apology was a duel, I'd be winning it. Eritus is silly. Master Renio, here comes some bad voice acting. Enough! The airship master says, hands clenched before him as though he means to seize Eritus by his doublet and toss him from the launch platform. You stole my airship! It's too late for apologies! Are you sure? Eritus says, cocking his head. I could make up at least three more if it'll help. But Master Renio isn't listening. I demand compensation! My vessel, my source of livelihood, snatched by this vagrant! He stares hard at the oblivious glaive. I require justice! I will take it in the form of service! I could use intimidation or deception. I can ask if I can pay off his debt. I can tell Eritus, dude, you gotta work for this guy. Is there any other way we can resolve this?
I would prefer that the guilty party make amends, but I would accept monetary compensation for the losses.
Okay, nobody here can afford to pay for a whole fucking airship, I can tell you that right now. He shakes his head.
I doubt the young thief has the money at hand, however.
Making a note. He pries at the bridge of his nose with ink-smudged fingers.
I'd consider bringing the matter of compensation before the council clerk, but we've had a number of arguments in the recent past. I doubt he'll help me.
You're probably right. Let's discuss something else.
Of course,
he says, straightening his clothes. We'll figure something out later. In the meantime, I have other questions.
Go on, I suppose.
Farewell.
Ah, farewell!
Eritus? He's so happy to see me again that he's red in the face and shaking a little. I'll get his forgiveness or die trying. Alright, let's go talk to the clerk. I want to see what the clerk has to say about this situation. Master Renio insisted Eritus pay his debt in the form of service unless I can convince him to accept some other solution. Renio would accept monetary compensation from the city authorities, assuming they're willing to provide them. If I want to pursue this, I'll have to petition the council clerk in Government Square. Why would the city pay for it? In what world?
Learning begets doing.
Does a dude steal your fucking car, wreck and total your car, and the city's like, we'll pay for this? What the fuck kind of wonderful city are they living in that just pays for your... Daddy's gonna pay for your crash car. That's a song by YouTube. By YouTube? Did I just say by YouTube? It's not a song by YouTube, in fact. I don't think that YouTube, the company, actually is in the business of creating songs. It's a song by U2. Not YouTube. U2. The Irish band. U2. Called Daddy's Gonna Pay for Your Crashed Car. And that seems to be the case here. Well, I have a working relationship with the council clerk. We've done business. We've come to an understanding. The council clerk and I, you know, we have a grudging mutual respect, right? I don't know. We're gonna find out. Council clerk. The clerk notes your approach, as an anine would note the return of a particularly ravenous bloodfly. An annoyance to be addressed and driven off, lest matters grow worse. What is it this time? I'd like to talk about paperwork. A faint sigh is the only acknowledgement you receive. I am trying to resolve a legal dispute between two men named Eretus and Renio. Eretus crashed an airship of Renio's. Can you help? Do you think that because I can make a document vanish at the snap of my fingers, I can do the same for a civil suit? He shakes his head with slow condescension. It's not so easy. The only relief the city could provide would be taking over Eretus's liability for the accident through a certificate of indemnity.
But why would they do that? It doesn't even make sense to me.
But I assure you, the council does not take on such liability willy-nilly. Nor does it grant its clerk discretion to fritter away the city's money.
He stares at you with two eyes.
Only someone much more important than you or I could persuade the council to do such a thing. Have you such a friend?
Oh, I bet if I would have helped Lord Vuntgen and not pissed him off, then I could invoke his name right here, and it would help me. Customary gratuity. I could lie, but I can't make up the name of a council member. This dude is gonna know all the council members, and all the council members going back decades, probably. So... He won't be fooled by me making up a council member. Now, if I knew that there was actually a council member named Crispus Horatius, then sure. Why can't you just give it to me?
The clerk sighs in exasperation. A well-ordered city is a powerful, implacable machine. A passerby cannot change its operation merely by jumping up and down and shouting. Nor does a mere cog have the power or volition to act on its own. Rather, one must cry out to those whose hands are on the levers of power.
How can I find someone who could help me?
Finding the powerful is never difficult. Their glory shines like a beacon over the entire city. Look among the slave families for one who needs assistance of the sort your kind provides.
I don't appreciate that condescension, buddy. He smirks.
Even the mighty, especially the mighty, understand the principle of quid pro quo.
And so does Hannibal Lecter. Quid pro quo, Clarice. I can't do a Hannibal Lecter voice. I can't make myself sound like Anthony Hopkins, but you remember it. If you haven't seen Silence of the Lambs, what are you doing with your life? Go see it. Well, don't go see it. It's not like it's going to be in a theater or something. But check on Netflix or whatever other services you may have for watching things. If not, BitTorrent that shit. I'm not going to offer a customary gratuity. I'm too poor. I'm going to try the lie, even though I know this is not going to work out. I hoped a council member named Crispus Horatius find a missing cipher. I'm sure he'd approve. The clerk glares at you with one of his eyes. This is exactly what I just said. Did you truly believe I would not know by heart the names of all the city's luminaries? Would you tell me again how to find someone who might be able to help me? I feel like Lord Vuntgen was my one chance to get help with this. By the Black Three, he snaps. Are you an idiot? That's one of the best reactions we've gotten so far to asking the same question twice. Are you an idiot? He says. Yeah, I kinda am. Find a powerful person and render a favor. I don't know any.
I'll remember that.
He shrugs. Then your quest is denied. Farewell. The epic fail. So if I would have helped Lord Vuntgen, I could have gotten help on this. But as it is, I'm going to have to resolve this quest a different way. Well, I probably could have bribed him with a customary gratuity. But I don't want to pay any money. I don't have very much. The clerk gives no acknowledgement that he heard and merely continues with his work. Quest updated? Not really. The city will only pay for Renio's damages if I have the backing of someone influential. If such a person owes me a favor, I should return to the council clerk and tell him. No. That's not gonna work out. So, I guess we'll just go back and resolve it ourselves without any I didn't think the help from the city thing was realistically gonna happen anyway, so I just wanted to go check it out and see what happens when you ask him. And he said, are you an idiot? Honestly, I feel like asking someone if they're an idiot is even better and like a better insult than just calling someone an idiot. I feel if you look at somebody and you say, you're an idiot, that's easy to it's sort of easy to ignore or whatever. It doesn't have a lot of power. But asking someone, are you an idiot? Seems so much more brutal and awesome.
Here we go then.
Alright, Eritus, what's up, pal? Saying the same thing he was saying before. Alright, Master Renio, I got good news and bad news. Which do you want first? Because the good news... How does she have a might pool of 3 out of 1? What? That is super weird. Super, super, super weird. Hella crazy weird. Oh my god, it's weird. I should restore these pools, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. Alright, Master Renio. Can I just call you Master P? Master Renio is still glaring at Eritus.
Apologies will not settle this matter! I demand compensation for the airship you destroyed, and failing that, service.
Should I try the intimidation and deception? Can I pay off his debt?
Certainly. Though you'd be responsible for the cost of the airship's current value, filing fees, and assorted labor.
He raises his chin.
300 chins, and not one less.
Okay, no. And also, what? 300 chins is all an airship is worth? So why didn't somebody tell me this earlier when I had, like, 2,000 chins? I would have just bought myself an airship if you could get them for 300 chins. Shit. Maybe we can settle on another option. No, let's say that's far too much.
No, he says, his nostrils flaring. And I must say that I dislike the implication. I do not overcharge, ever. My costs are high, and my prices fairly measured.
He makes a visible attempt to swallow his anger.
This portion of our discussion is over. Perhaps you'd like to discuss other options.
Eretus, you owe Master Renio a debt. You should work with him until you've cleared it. But do I want to do that? Let's see what happens. Science. Oh, I just resolved it. Apparently. But am I happy with the way that I resolved it? Work? Eretus says, looking doubtful. I've done work. I never liked it much. It's too worky. Eretus is pretty funny.
Are you telling me that you can't turn working at an airship dock into an adventure?
What the fuck voice did I just do?
Are you telling me that you can't turn working at an airship dock into an adventure?
Of course I can! He says, offended at the very notion. He spins around, all determination, and offers his hand to the suddenly wary Renio.
I accept your offer. We will adventure together. Making a note. Wonderful,
Renio says after a moment's silence, as though he's trying to convince himself.
Good.
He turns to you with a small bow.
We will resume flights to the Valley of Dead Heroes soon. Thank you again for your help in this matter. Let's get started, Eretus.
So then Eretus is just gone. Well, no, he's standing right there. But I don't think I can have him as a companion now, for example. Right? That completes Airship Thief. I convinced Eretus to work for Renio in exchange for the damage he caused. This is exactly what Renio demanded, but I have a feeling he may not know what he's in for. He's just fidgeting. Yeah, I'm not thrilled with this outcome. I want to see what the other outcome is first. But we're going to load the save. Oh no, now the sound is going to be back. Why? Why, inXile? Why would you do this to me? The sound. Damn it. Hold on.
Of course.
I'm sorry, I have to get rid of the sound. I have to. I can't have that constantly going while I'm trying to read and shit. Can't have it. Alright.
Let's go.
Whoa, slow down, everybody on the internet flocking to my channel. Watch out for all these viewers, huh? Okay. We're back. We're gonna do it the other way now. For fun. For funsies. Is anybody good at intimidation in my crew? He's got one in it. He's got one in intimidation. I've got one in deception, and I'm much more intellecty than him. Did she use her flex skill? She didn't yet.
I mean, she could put a thing in intimidation, but she still doesn't have all that intellect edge, so there's no real point to it. Quick fingers. She's already incredibly good at quick fingers. Let's just keep her flex skill for now, unused.
Yes.
All right, Renio. Can I pay off his debt? That's far too much. How much does he owe again? Maybe we can settle on another option.
Let's be blunt. Eritus can't be held responsible for his actions. I mean, look at him.
I've got an 85% without spending any effort. Everybody else... Oh, wow. She's got a 5%. I think we can roll with 85. I could make it 100 by spending 1, but I don't feel like I need to. Damn it! Oh no, you know what this means? Do you know what this means? Hold on. Well, let's see what he said. He does so. Eritus is staring suspiciously at a passing mote of dust as though it intends to ambush him.
No! Him at be!
Master Renio lowers his voice to a whisper.
A complete scatterwit, but he has caused me grievous damage. Grievous! I demand compensation.
All right. It's time. It's time to hit F9 again. What is up, Nox Moo? Nox Moo in the house. Everybody moo, 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 moo. What's up, Nox? How you doing? Welcome. I've got the horrible sound going. Can I pay off his debt? Maybe we can settle on another option. Alright, 85%. Please do not fail this time. Thank you.
I'll remember that.
He does so. This is a great line. Eritus is staring suspiciously at a passing mote of dust as though it intends to ambush him.
You have a point,
Renio grunts at last.
He crashed my airship minutes after we first met. I can't imagine what would happen if I employed him.
That's a good point. He scowls at your companion.
Just keep him away from me and my livelihood. I'll be resuming flights to the Valley of Dead Heroes shortly. Good day to you.
Eritus stares between the two of you, utterly puzzled. He was either expecting more arguing or an outright fight. This civil discussion has apparently baffled him.
I'll go back to Cliff's Edge, he says, almost angrily. Things were more exciting there.
And he goes off grumbling. I'm doing well, thanks, Nox. Doing well. All right. Well, the airship thief. I convinced Renio to forgive Eritus's debt. Renio seemed to recognize that Eritus's service might prove more of a liability than an asset. Yeah, that guy's a fucking disaster. He's a fucking disaster. It's like everything he does has Saito's dread touch. All right, let's do a little level up thingy. I can increase edge. I can increase my pools a little bit. Or I could improve a skill. Or improve an ability. Let's improve a skill. Which skill do I want to increase? Well, natural lore might be good. Or machinery lore. Or more anamnesis. Or more cipher use. Or some concentration. Would not hurt. Or some intimidation. Or I can improve persuasion or deception. I'm going to double up on anamnesis.
I understand now.
That's what I'm gonna do. That is what I am going to do. What's up, Tabir? As you pass a stack of cargo, a familiar figure steps out from behind it, disguised, entirely unconvincingly, as an Aeon Priest.
Hello again, lass, says Tabir. I don't suppose you're ready to change your mind about me joining you.
Why are you hiding?
Ah, well, it seems Riss is still unhappy with me for leaving him on the gibbet for so long. And he wants to strangle me with my own entrails to show me how it felt. I, naturally, am less enthusiastic about the lesson and would like to avoid it if at all possible. He takes a breath, finally. Therefore, I was hoping that I might join you. For protection, if you see what I mean. Strength in numbers and all that.
Strength in numbers? Do you mean that if you join me, we're in danger of Riss attacking us?
Tabir waves his hands.
No, I mean the exact opposite. Riss is an utter coward. As long as you're with me, he won't dare attack. He won't even show his face.
I'm not interested, thank you. Wait, that's all I can say? Oh, because I don't have a spot in the group. I have to kick somebody out of the group first, then get another person to join me. That's how it works in this game.
Are you sure? I'm a man of the world. I know my way around a lot of places.
No, thank you.
Good luck to you, then, I guess.
Alright, Master Renio, he's probably ready to fly us the fuck out of here right now, if I want. I'm not gonna fly out yet, because I'm not done with everything here, but... He turns from his observation of the laborers and asks,
How may I assist you?
Yeah, I could tell him I need to fly, but I'm not ready for that. Farewell.
Yes.
Alright. So that quest is done. Do I have anything else to talk to the orphans about? No.
Trust and honesty are our bonds.
What's gonna happen next? Well, I wanna go talk to Eretus some more. So, off we go. Fifth eye bar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 eyes. That's why they call it the fifth eye. Which one is the fifth, though? Probably this one in the prominent place in the middle.
All right.
Dude whose neck I snapped still just laying there. Alright, is Eretus just chilling over? Yeah, he is.
Right, Ren. You can do this.
Let's go talk to Eretus. Let's go talk to Eretus. Eretizzle. What does this guy even look like up close?
Let's go.
Alright, this guy looks like he just came out of a fucking recent Final Fantasy game or something. Alright. Quick save. And Eretus talk.
Greetings! Are you ready to travel together yet? Have amazing adventures!
Seriously, what is that glow surrounding you?
What glow?
He says, looking behind him.
How did you crash the airship again?
I didn't! It crashed itself while I was flying it toward the fallen star in the reef!
Maybe you can join me another time. I already have too many people with me.
That's all right, he says, shifting impatiently from foot to foot. I can wait!
See you later.
So I need to kick somebody out temporarily. So I can... So, Allegern, buddy. I'm gonna need you to step out of the party for just a minute. Now, I'm gonna take all your stuff. But don't be alarmed. Don't be alarmed.
Oh, that's how he has a training level in intimidation. I should have trained in concentration. I could have worn one of these bonded thingies.
She's got 1 out of 3, 5 out of 5, 4 out of 4. Just load up. She's got cipher sickness, minus 2 speed pool. We're just gonna make sure, just in case, if something weird happens when we transfer you out of the party and back in, and you lose all your shit or something. So we're taking all your shit, and then we're kicking you to the curb. Goodbye for now, Allegern. Goodbye for now, my friend. Well, friend-ish. I think it's best we part.
And here I thought we were getting along so splendidly.
The irony in his voice is betrayed by the hurt in his eyes. Oh, quit crying.
But fine. If you need me again, find me at my workshop. It's in the underbelly. So long.
Bye. All right, Eridus, welcome to the team, buddy.
Greetings! Are you ready to travel together yet? Have amazing adventures?
I changed my mind. I want you to join me.
Of course you do! And I'm ready! I'm always ready! Are we heading into a fight, or should I start one?
Oh my god, look at this guy. Look at that portrait! This fucking dude. Seriously. He's got some shitty pools. Oh, he's pro-
So be it. What? Are we ready to go? What? Are we ready to go? Onward! What? Are we ready to go? Is there more danger? So be it.
Alright, let's talk to him. Catch Eritus staring at the sky with a distant look in his eyes. His strangely pale skin is nearly bronze in the golden glow surrounding him.
I should climb a building. No, a tower. And jump off the top. Should it be on fire? Yes. Yes and yes.
This guy's cool.
Sounds fun. When do we start?
Oh, not today, he says. We have things to do, I think. Don't we?
That distant look resurfaces, along with a need so deep it approaches hunger.
Anyway, I'm just planning ahead, for if things get,
He grimaces as if the word he's trying to say pains him.
Boring?
Yes! He shudders. I have to be moving. Boring seconds turn into boring minutes, then entire hours where nothing happens. And then you're dead of old age, he says, wiping away tears. But you aren't here to talk about me, he says, then blinks. Or are you?
I have some questions about you.
I'm not surprised, he says, pleased.
I'm incredibly interesting. What do you want to know? I've never heard the name Eretus before. What does it mean? Names mean things? He says, gaping. I thought they were just there to put words on faces. He frowns. It should mean fast or impossibly handsome, but I really have no idea. Do you know what your name means? He says, turning to your other companions.
Bloodnucker.
Madkina mumbles, giving you a murderous look. What? I didn't catch... Blood Dancer, Madkina growls. That's what it means, and I don't want to talk about it.
Blood Dancer, that's a badass. You're just guaranteed to be an edgelord when your name starts out as Blood Dancer.
I like that!
Eretus says wistfully, after a respectful pause.
I hope mine doesn't mean flower picker, though flowers are very nice. Hold on, he says, ripping a much-folded page from his doublet. This sounds like an exciting quest to set off on someday.
He writes furiously, tongue peeking from between his teeth.
Discover secret meaning of name. Done!
He tucks the page back into his doublet, grinning. Okay, I love this guy.
Where do you come from? I came out of the West, Eretus declares, his glow intensifying, traveling day and night to escape the hired killers, hounding my every step. That's not what I meant. Where did you come from originally? From the storms of the South. At first, I think it was only an outline in the clouds of dust, but then...
Eretus leans forward, palms spread, eyes wide.
I emerged! Swords in every hand! Cape swirling! You should have been there!
I don't think you're understanding me. Where were you born?
That's a strange question, he says, his glow dimming. Babies aren't interesting.
Then he brightens, literally, of course.
You're asking when I realized I was a hero!
No, I'm trying to figure out your literal place of birth, Eretus, where you grew up.
Who knows? He says, waving a careless hand. Who cares? Heroes come from villages, so that's probably where I'm from. A village.
Where do you come from again?
Probably some boring village. I don't really remember. Let's talk about something else.
What is that glow surrounding you?
What glow?
Seriously, what is that glow surrounding you?
What glow?
Let's talk about something else. Eretus blinks.
How are things between us? You don't even need to ask, he says.
His eyes glisten with the barest hint of tears.
I'd think we were twins if we didn't have different parents.
Eretus blinks. I want your opinion of the people we're traveling with. So there wasn't very much to talk to him about.
Oh, I like them, he says airily. They keep things from getting too quiet or thoughtful. They get in the way of mirrors, and I appreciate that.
He blinks several times.
Oh, you want more specific details. Who about?
You mentioned that you don't like mirrors. Why is that?
I did, he says, blinking. What a strange thing to say. Who doesn't like mirrors? I certainly don't.
Wait. He frowns. His golden aura fades until it almost isn't there.
I like mirrors, he says finally. I have no problem with them. Let's talk about something else.
Oh, Eretus is hiding something. Let's talk about something else. I want your opinions of the people we're traveling with.
Opinions? I love giving those.
Madkina?
She's kind, smart, and beautiful, he says, blushing a little. Also, I hate to admit this, but I think she might be a better fighter than I am.
He sighs happily.
Don't tell her I said any of that, all right?
Yes! Finally! We have some acknowledgement of the fact that everyone is standing right here listening to these conversations. He said, don't tell her I said any of that, all right? Matkina immediately.
I am literally standing right here.
She turns to you.
Is he messing with me?
Ah! He says, flinching away from her. Did I mention she's stealthy? She's the stealthiest woman I've ever fallen in love with. Matt! And that's Kina. She's kind, smart, and beautiful. Don't tell her I said that. She said I'm literally standing right here. That was so good. What about Rin? I like her a lot, he says, smiling. She wants to explore and understand things. I like exploring, too.
What about understanding things?
No time. It gets in the way of the exploring. Oh, Aratus is great. I'm sad that he doesn't have much more to talk to him about, though. There's not much depth to his conversation tree compared to the others, but... He's pretty fucking funny, though.
Let's talk about something else. Let's talk him another time.
Good idea! Alright, let's check him out. Let's check this goofy fucker out. So be it. Alright. He's tier 1. He's not even tier 2. His descriptor is overly impulsive. He's an overly impulsive glaive who is as heroic as he believes himself to be. Nice. His overly impulsive descriptor says, act first, let someone else ask questions later. If then! Aratus has yet to see a downside to this plan. I love this guy. Alright. Bogus is as heroic as he believes himself to be. Aratus is a hero because he believes himself to be so. The more heroic his actions, the more powerful and self-fulfilling they become. So he's a glaive fighter with a great sword. And, he's got shitty pools, though. A lot of armor, no resistance. Evasion and willpower. So he's not exactly an ass-whipping machine so far. Aratus' undershirt. It's poorly matched to the rest of his outfit. He has knotted his belt across it in a way he would undoubtedly describe as dashing. And his doublet. Aratus' quality doublet is of a simple cut. He wears it over a frumpy, mismatched shirt. No matter how much he spins, leaps, or rolls around, the doublet remains spotless. Despite its casual appearance, it offers him protection. Alright, and he's got... Opportunist. Make an attack against the first enemy that moves within range. Practiced in armor. Okay, this is kind of dumb. I mean, he's a glaive, so he gets standard glaive shit. But what's the point of him having practice in armor if you can never unequip this crappy armor and give him real armor? Just asking. 10% critical success on weapon attacks. Never boring is the name of one of his abilities. Armor's weight means little to you. While others rattle and stumble, you move through battle with calm assurance. In the midst of combat, you withdraw, creating an opening, and the fool who tries to take advantage of it quickly discovers her mistake. Your keen eye and your unerring strikes drive your foes to their knees. Now, never boring. One-on-one duels are not Aratus' style. He's far more effective leaping from enemy to enemy, dealing deadly wounds and giggling beneath his breath. He bounces around the battlefield, gaining plus 20% critical hit chance whenever he attacks a new target. That's interesting. Subtlety isn't very heroic. Smashing things is. By following Aratus' heroic example, all party members are much better at breaking things into small, cowardly pieces. Everybody gets 5% on melee, 5% on smashing, 5% on initiative. That's cool, I guess. He's got a little endurance, initiative, running and smashing, melee weapons, he sucks at concentration. So that's Eretus. Well, I'm not keeping him. He's funny, but I'm not keeping him. I'm getting Allegern back. So Eretus, I bid you farewell, sir. Thanks for joining, but it's time for you to go. The moment you look his way, Eretus stuffs a creased scrap of paper back into his doublet with a guilty expression. A stubby pencil tumbles from his hands to the ground beside his boot. Hiding something? No, he says, averting his gaze. The golden glow surrounding him dims and he winces. Yes, he declares a moment later. I can't hide anything from you. He locks his eyes on you in a way that tells you he is very specifically not looking at Matt Kena. I can't hide anything from anyone, he admits. It was a letter with poems in it. A poetry letter with the best words I know. I didn't know you could write. Oh, I can, he says seriously. I'm the best at everything I do without even trying. Sword fighting, backflips, writing, beast taming. Though I have to admit, the last stanza was giving me trouble. His glow fades by slivers. Couldn't find a rhyme for disemboweled. His eyes glitter with exhaustion. I should probably start over. Who are you writing this letter to? He says, swallowing, eyes locked on his boots. A special woman. I'm not ready to tell you who she is, but you know her too. I'd say she stole my heart, but she's an assassin, not a thief. Yeah, he's not ready to tell me. It's pretty fucking obvious. Matt Kena is so sick of this shit already. Great weeping mechanical gods, Matt Kena mutters, massaging her eyes. You must think I'm acting strange, Eretus says, sighing. You're older and more experienced in the ways of love. He smashes his hand with his palm. But I'm the best at anything I try. She'll fall in love with me if I say the right thing. I know it. Hold on. More experienced in the way of love? Yes, Eretus says, blinking. You're old. You must have thousands of romantic conquests already. I'm not old. I don't think she's interested in you, Eretus. How do you know? Eretus says, frowning. I never told you her name. Besides, it doesn't matter. I have to follow my heart, even if it leads me off a cliff. He brightens, especially if it does. Atkina grumbles under her breath. Anyway, he says, shedding his serious expression like an unwelcome blanket. What did you need? I have some questions about you. Are there any new questions? Nope. Let's split up for now. Now? Really? But we're just getting started. He slumps a little, his glow fading. I'll be here in Cliff's Edge, he says, sighing. Meeting strangers, telling stories, doing tricks, seeing how long I can hold my breath. Radiant once more, he waves at you and bolts off. Wonder if anyone else crashed an airship. Eretus is pretty great. All right. Now let's see if I can summon... Let's see if I can summon Allegern back to us by using the bronze sphere. You pull the whorled orb from your bags. The sigil buttons rise obediently from its surface, waiting to be pressed. Tap the button showing a sword made of tiny swords. You poke the button and hear Eretus' voice within your mind. I wonder what would happen if I dueled myself! Press the cage sigil. You press the cage sigil with your thumb and hear Allegern's voice in your head as though from a great distance.
Doesn't make sense, he mutters, accompanied by the clinking of tools. It's like this thing wants to be broken.
Allegern, I need you to join me.
Huh?
Allegern says in your mind.
Oh, it's you. Sure, kid.
Allegern abruptly appears beside you, wobbling on his feet a little. Put the orb away. Welcome back, Allegern. Hey, Jackstor, welcome back. Good to see you again. How are you doing? Alright, now we can give Allegern his shit back. Here you go. Here you go. Here you go. Give you one of these. Here you go. Equip that, equip that, equip that. Equip that. Give him back the capture ball. Give him back the conflict advisor. Give him back the ring of El Amor. I'm going to give the Dance of Sharp Angles to Nat Kina, actually. That way I have an open cipher slot. Jackstor is mooing at Noxmoo. Noxmoo is mooing at Jackstor. There's a lot of mooing going on. I'm doing pretty good. Thanks, Jackstor. You're doing great. Wow, that sounds very positive. Not just good, not just okay, not just alright, not just decent, not just fine, but great! You're like a bowl of frosted flakes. Because they're great! Do they still do the They're Great ads with Tony the Tiger? Or am I just talking about some really, really old shit right now? From way back in the olden days. From like before the Great War. Alright, we're done talking to Aratus. We sadly have to let him go. I would love it if you could take just one more person in your party. I mean, there's room down here in the UI. Just one more person. Then I would definitely take Aratus, but... So, anyway, you think they're not so great anymore? I see. End of an era, I guess. Let's look at the quest journal. Infested Fathom, return to Omadon, Anechoic Lazaret, and Loss of Self. Alright, let's go back to the Fifth Eye Bar. It's time for more of that. Fifth Eye Bar, we're going in.
Go.
All right, we're going to talk to everybody in here, starting with this clarion person who's right in front of us, apparently.
I'll handle it.
Is it my imagination, or is everything kind of blurry in here? Maybe it's just our characters. Maybe it's just where we're standing. Things don't look... Well, maybe they do kind of look blurry. Look at this, there's glasses levitating, cups levitating over here and being filled up without the bartender having to touch them. Wait, does he even have hands?
Doesn't even look like he's got... He might have one there. Looks like he might be missing a hand. Here's the crazy ghost that just kills you. This yellow shirt guy. I told the whole story about yellow shirt guy.
Stick by me. I'll keep you safe.
I was planning to hide.
Honestly, I was hoping to hide with you.
Oh, they're bonding. Alright, let's talk to Clarion.
Of course.
Quick save. You know what, let's do a real save. Number 17. Clarion. Oh, we should hold off on this conversation a minute. Because I need to end my episode here. If you're watching the stream, don't go anywhere. Because I am not done playing and streaming. But, if you are watching on YouTube, that is going to do it for this episode. So thank you for watching. This has been Josiah Plays... Torment, Tides of Numenera.